Hey everybody and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be talking about the KKW and Mario, the Artist in the Muse collection. I just recently bought the KKW and Mario eyeshadow palette just because I really wanted it for ages, and the blush as well just because it was a gorgeous colour. So we're just going to do a wee review on them and show you what they look like on the eyes and the type of look you can create. If that's what you want to see, just keep on watching. To prep my skin, I'm going to go on with the Nivea Refreshingly Soft Moisturising Cream, and the reason I'm using this is just because I have really dry skin, and it just depends on what type of day I'm having with my skin that I'll decide to use my moisturisers. I actually have another one here from L'Oreal Hydrogenious, which is actually for more dry to normal kind of skin, and the day is just really dry, so I'm going to use the Nivea Soft Refreshingly Moisturising Cream, and I'm just going to pat it all around my face. And how cute's my mommy? I asked her, does she have anything so that I can hold my hair back instead of my hat? She gave me this sweet pink headband. So cute. What I'm going to use next now is my Mario Badescu facial spray with aloe herbs and rose water. And I'm just going to use this to spray around my face using the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Soft Matte Longwear Foundation in the shade 200. And I'm just going to take my CMB foundation brush and just dot that on. Once that you've just dotted it on, I would just start patting it under the skin. So I use a brush because it gives a more full coverage look, and that's, I love full coverage on myself particularly, but I love full coverage. So I'm just going to pat it under the skin rather than swipe it so that I don't get the brush strokes on the skin. Now that my foundation's all on, I'm just going to take my Kevin Aucoin, and it's the Sensual Skin Enhancer, which is just a concealer, and I'm just going to put it on my under eyes now. So I've left a gap between my foundation and my under eye just because I crease easily under my under eye, so don't want to put my foundation right up there then put my concealer there. This is really full coverage, is the reason I'm going to just use it straight under my under eyes. And I'm just going to use Doll Beauty DB11 brush, and I'm just gonna pat some concealer right underneath my eye. This is my concealer all on now in the placement where I like to put it. I just feel like whenever the light hits you in this spot, it just makes it look more foxed and winged out and pulled. And it's just such a refreshing look. It's gorgeous actually whenever you take photos especially. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my J Cats concealer in Vanilla Bean, and I'm just gonna pop a wee bit on underneath the eyes for extra brightening up, just because I like underneath the eyes to be really bright and so that the attention goes towards this area. And what I'm just going to use this brush here. It's just a fluffy brush, it's not any brand or anything, it's just some brush I have in my kit, and I'm just going to start to blend it out now. Now that the concealer and the foundation's both on, what I'm going to do is take my CMB Shady Stick, which is the best shady stick, or the best contour stick that I think's out there at the moment. It's really, really good. I'm going to put it in the back of my hand and just rub it about and warm it up instead of going straight onto the face. And I'm going to take my MF2 brush from the Mitchell collection, and I'm just going to rub on the brush some product, tap it off, and then lightly start to place it on my cheek. Whenever you suck on like a fish, when you suck on like a fish, like so, you'll see that you have two lines that appear kind of there, and that's where you want your contour placement to be. And I usually flick it up rather than down, just because I want my face to be kind of lifted and sculpted rather than looking like it's going down and dreary. I want my cheeks to kind of come up rather than drip down. I put it on my forehead too, just to bronze it up a bit, because my forehead's massive. Then I put it on my nose just to make my nose a bit smaller because it's also massive, and a wee bit under my lip, and then the non-existent jawline, which I now have to create. A lot of people's been like messaging me on Insta, and it's been so great. I'm so thankful for the support I've received, especially on the last video, like my first proper YouTube video, which was the last one that I just did. I'm so thankful for all the support I've been receiving through DMs and just comments and likes and new subscribers and all. It's been great. My YouTube to be a place where you can come now, especially with lockdown and stuff. I just want it to be a place where you can come chill, feel safe, and not stress about school, because I know for a fact I should be doing schoolwork and I'm so stressed. But the only way that I'm going to de-stress is just to do my makeup, take a wee bit of time to myself, and then tomorrow go back at it. Off camera, I just went ahead and I applied my HMB Cosmetics Soft Focus Loose Powder. I used the shade Fair underneath my eyes where my concealer was, and I used the shade Banana, I think it is, around the rest of my face, just the perimeters. And as you can notice, my face is still kind of dewy looking, which is the thing I love about these powders, is they'll not make your face look too matte and you'll still have a bit of luminosity, because I don't like my face to look too dry, because obviously I have dry skin and I just love the glowy look these days. So the powders are great and they retail for about £12-13-ish on the HMB Cosmetics website. Unreal. Next, I'm just going to go on with the Fenty Beauty Sunstalker in Island Tang, and it's just a bronzer for my face, and I'm just going to bring back some warmth to the perimeters of my face now. I'm using the CMB Cosmetics Magic Wand Brush. Now we're just going to go on to the first product that we're actually going to be testing today, which is the KKW and Mario, the Artist and the Muse blush. So this blush is in the shade, what does it say? Very Graceful. I can't wait to show you this blush. But how cute is this packaging? It's like a matte grey finish all around, and then you come to the front and it's like a shiny writing that says KKW times Mario, and it's the queen herself and the king of makeup. If you do not know who Mario Dedovanovich is, he's the king of makeup. He does Kim Kardashian's makeup all the time, especially for the Met Gala. I think it was 2019 when she done the white look. It was unreal. So this is the blusher here, and the packaging's just kind of like a frosted packaging, and we're just going to go ahead and open it. So the first thing I'm going to say is that to open that, that was extremely, extremely difficult. It's really well sealed, but it's well sealed to the point that it's actually really hard to open. But it's open now, and this is the colour of the blush. It's a peachy coral kind of tone blush, and it is absolutely beautiful. So I've actually never tried it before, so I'm going to go on light with my DB10 brush from Doll Beauty. I'm just going to tap off any excess on the side. And just slowly build it up until I reach the colour that I want to do. That's lovely, that's quite natural. Oh, it's just so natural looking, I love it. And again, on the bridge of the nose. As you can see, the blush is just applying now on my cheeks. It's just absolutely gorgeous. It's really subtle, and you can build it up if you want a really more intense blush, but I'm kind of happy with what I have here. The highlighter that I'm going to go on with now is Showstopper from the Mrs. Glam by Michelle palette, and it is so blinding. Just want to see what this looks like whenever it goes on. So to do my brows, I'm just going to use the Anastasia Brow Wiz in the shade Dark Brown. Give them a wee brush and just make sure that they're pointing the right direction that I want them. Whenever I'm filling on my brows, what I like to do first is map out the bottom line of the brow, and then I'll go under the arch and then start filling in. Usually because I don't really do much to my eyebrows, because it's just my eyebrows are kind of more full in a way as it is. I just want to fill in the kind of sparser areas, and then I'll go on with my brow gel after. So I'm just going to start here at the front, bring in that line, straight across to where I want it to be. So I'm happy with what I have now, and I'm just going to go ahead and begin the arch. I'm just going to go ahead and go in now and start to fill in some fake hairs in between, just to make my brow look more full. After you give your brows a brush through, what I'm going to do is go in with the Anastasia Brow Gel in Dark Brown again. I'm just going to tap off the top, and I'm just going to lightly go in and brush through the brows just to make them stay in place and define them just slightly more. So I'm going to go ahead and do the other brow off camera. So that's both eyebrows done off camera now, and what I've already prepped my eyes and carved my eyebrows with the P. Louise Bis just in Rumour 2. So the first brush I'm going to go in with is the Doll Beauty DB13 brush, and it's just a blending brush, and I'm just going to make sure once again this is completely flat before I put eyeshadow on it. And the first colour I'm going to go on with is this colour right here, which is Miami. and I want this color to be my crease color, my transition color, before I apply any other colors. So I'm going to make sure that I get a fair amount of this on. I'm just going to use my CMB Cosmetics E2 brush and the same shade Miami again. I'm just going to buff it out. And kind of what I like to do with eyeshadows especially is bring them to this point where the brow meets the nose, just to kind of blend it all together. So now that my first color is on in the shade Miami, I'm just going to go on with my second color, which is this darker brown shade here, the outer V. So this is where my lash line meets my crease in kind of like a V shape. And I'm going to use my DB13 brush just to do that. So now that I put on the shade Loyalty in my outer V and kind of brought it under my crease a wee bit, I'm just going to use this smaller tippered blending brush just to blend it out under the crease. This is just going to add a wee bit more definition to the eye look as well and just make everything blend nice and seamlessly together. And the one thing I'm noticing about these eyeshadows is that they really blend easily, but there's a wee bit of fallout in the pan, which is not a problem for me. I don't really mind, but just in case some users don't like that, but they're blending really, really easily so far, and it's the perfect color scheme for each other. Now I'm going to check my CMB E2 brush again, and I'm just going to make sure that everything's blended. And the way I want to do it is I kind of want to bring it out and smoke it out a wee bit more towards the temple area, just because I want this look to be kind of fox-eyed. So I'm just going to lift it. So now that it's blended all out, I'm going to go on with the blue shade here, which is the shade Libra. And it looks absolutely stunning, so I can't wait to put this one on my eyes. What I'm going to do is just go on and start dabbing the shade and coating the brush with that blue, because what I've noticed is that sometimes your finger can do better with metallic shades than a brush can anyway, but I'm going to use this first and then I'm going to go on with my finger and tap. So this is kind of just like a base before I go on with my finger and a wee bit of pigment. What I love about these type of looks is that they are so like glam, but they can be editorial, and this palette is so versatile. You have your browns, just your simple browns for someone that doesn't wear a lot of makeup, and then you have your gold shades for if you want to go full glam, and then you have just that hint of blue and like a kind of maroon kind of color just for like just to spice things up a wee tiny bit. So I'm just gonna blend that right up under the crease. So what I'm going to do now that I've kind of already prepped it with brushes, and I'm just going to take a wee bit of my finger, like how blue is that, and I'm just going to pull it on my eye now. We are going to take the Inglot Pure Pigment Eyeshadow in, I don't know what shade this is, I think it's AMC, but I'm not sure. It's a kind of blue eyeshadow anyway, and just to intensify that blue ever so slightly, we're just going to take some of that pigment and we're going to pop it on the eye. Just because I want this blue to be beaming. Once we've done that, I'm just going to go back in with my wee blending brush. I don't actually already do Madison Makeup, it's from, don't know what type of brush, and I'm just going to go back in with the shade Loyalty, which is the darker shade we used to darken up the outer V, and I'm just going to blend it in towards the blue just to give a nice gradient and make sure that it's not too harsh. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take ever so slightly, just a wee tiny bit of the shade Vegas, which is the kind of maroon kind of metallic shade that we were looking at, and I'm just going to plop that beside the blue so that it can transition into the brown. Again, just going back in with the brush that I have with my blue and just making sure that everything's nice and blended. This is kind of just like trial and motion kind of movements. You're just going with the flow and seeing how it looks on the eye. I'm using my E2 brush again. I'm just going to buff out that blue shadow and make sure it doesn't look too structured on the eye. So I've just gone ahead and applied my top eyeliner, and now what I'm going to do is take the shade Just Black from the Clientele palette, and I'm just going to smoke it out towards the very outer edge of the eye. Users can use, but does any of users watch Keeping Up with the Kardashians? Like, I love Keeping Up with the Kardashians. So I went and bought this palette, and then just after I bought it, they started like they started filming the last couple of episodes of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, so I thought it was perfect timing. And I'm just so sad that it's going to be ending. Like, I'm an OG Kardashian fan. Do you remember the episodes when, like, at the very, very start, it was when Kim just started to get famous and Kris was her momager, obviously, and Scott and Courtney only started going with each other recently, just before it, and stuff like that. There, it was just unreal episodes, and it was just quality content, and I'm just going to miss it so much. So this palette is my memorabilia for Keeping Up with the Kardashians. So now I'm just going to take a wee bit of Dirty Tan, which is another shade in the Clientele palette, and I'm just going to buff all this out together. So this look is very editorial and also very glam. Like, you could wear this out if you were Darren, if you done looks like this, but I just think it's a gorgeous look. I think the pop of blue is just a perfect pop to your eyeshadow color, just to make it a wee bit different. So I'm gonna go ahead and do my under eyes now, and I will be straight back. So now that my under eyes are all done, I'm just gonna go ahead and do the inner corner highlight, and I'm actually gonna use this wee shade here because it looks unreal, and it is the shade 2008. It's a really silver tone shade as well. Oof. I love how Kim Kardashian named these shades after like really monumental moments. Like, 2008 would have been, this color is exactly representative of that time period, especially when she used to wear makeup around that time period. I remember looking back and being like, it's so silver, and there was a lot of pigment on the eyes, and it was more metallic colors. So anyways, now I'm just gonna go on with this shade right here, which is the shade Armenian. And if you didn't know, Kim Kardashian's heritage is Armenian, so it's great to see that she has a shade named after her heritage. I'm just going to use that wee shade to highlight my brow bone. And just add a wee bit more depth. Do you know what? I'm actually going to put a wee bit of Armenian on my normal highlight as well, just because it's so beautiful. So this is the final look with the KKW and Mario Dedovanovich palette and blusher. So that's them there, and this is what I've created. So it is a half cock crease with a blue tone mixing with your browns. So it's really, really good for creating looks like that. You can be more natural, or you could just add like a pop of colour like this or this. This one's actually beautiful as well. That's on the outer portion of it. But anyways, that is the finished look, and I hope you all enjoyed it, and I hope you took something away from the video. So if you enjoyed the video, just leave it a like and a comment and a wee subscribe button down here as well. And I'll see you on Thursday for my next video. Bye.